Hello everyone, I'm near Freshford today because I decided I would map the Freshford Loop, which is, the route is already mapped, but I thought I'd add all the trail markers and whatever else I can find along the route. And I found something here. I don't really know what it is. I thought it was a lime kiln. It's not that. It might be a holy well because there's a little pathway in and then some chamber. I'll have to figure that out. But anyway, I'll show you how to add all the trail markers and stuff when I'm back home from this very long walk, which is very much slowed down by me stopping at every trail marker and all that. Well, it's a glorious day, so I won't complain. I'm using OSMAnd for this video and for the tracking, and it's a really, really good app that I didn't give enough credit to in earlier videos. I'm very sorry about that. When you get OSMAnd, I'm pretty sure it is available for Android and for iPhones. You can download the map material, which in your case will probably be Ireland, and it's not that much compared to other countries. And then you can use it offline, which is great because you don't want to use up your data when you're out in the woods and up a mountain and, you know, there's no reception or whatever. So that's a really good thing about OSMAnd, and you can do so many things that I haven't even explored all of them. But I might do a couple more videos about OSMAnd. But the one important thing to do when you want to use it for tracking is you have to activate the plugin for that. So you go to your menu, recognizable by the three lines, and somewhere it says plugins here. And you click on that and you have to activate the trip recording here. And just click enable. And you can see you can also use Wikipedia offline, which is a great another great feature. And then you can also add audio video notes, which I hadn't activated and regretted afterwards. You can also use it for you to record where your car is parked. It's great. You can also use it for OpenStreetMap editing in a limited capacity. And there are other things that you can do. But this is the important thing for this video, is that you activate the trip recording. And you have to have your map material downloaded, and then somewhere, it's a bit tricky to find, you can also connect to your OpenStreetMap account, which is useful because we're going to upload the track afterwards and work on it on OpenStreetMap. It's probably somewhere in the settings, but I can't find it again. There are videos about that though. But let's pretend you've done all that already. And you're out and about and you want to track a hiking route, which, as I said, this is already mapped, the route, and it says Freshford Loop here because that's what it's called. So let's say you come across a trail marker that you want to add, and I remember that there was one here, somewhere here, let's say it's here. You just, like you do on your phone, you just hold your finger on the screen for a while, this pops up. So this comes up, there's no address here because it's in the forest. And you can see here, nearby a Wikipedia article, there's nothing there because nobody has written anything about that area. So you click on actions and then you have different options here. And at the beginning I used the OSM node, and I later on decided that I would use that for things that aren't to do with the hiking route, and like house numbers, street names, stuff like that that I came across. But you want to add a track waypoint, so that's what you click here. New menu appears, and then you can type in, let's say, trail marker, and you can number them like I did, or you didn't just not do that. Some of them had a little description of how to continue on the way, and I do regret that I didn't take note of that. You can add that in the description. So if anyone else wants to do the Freshford Loop, please add those as well. And you can delete them. You can also make a group. I did that. I made a group for styles. I don't know, it just lets you give them different colors up there. And another group for trail markers. That's what you can do. And you can also, if you're not doing a hiking route, you can choose symbols from down here if you wanted to. And you can choose the color and so on and so forth. I'll just save that. And just walk on, and I can't show you that now because I'm at home. And the little blue dot will follow you around. And in the end, you save your track. You have to start by pressing record first. So that's the first step. And then you add all the trail markers and save it. And when you're finished tracking, you go into the menu and go to My Places. And it'll list all the tracks you've done. You have to click on tracks first up at the top. And then you open that one and you see it on the screen. And you can then upload to OpenStreetMap. And of course, you have to be logged in with your OSMAnd app into your OpenStreetMap account. And then you can give it another description. And click upload. Or you can also add another tag there, which I did, just add a tagging. Doesn't really make a difference. So once you have uploaded your track onto OpenStreetMap, where do you find it? You go onto OpenStreetMap.org, you log in with your username, the same one that you use on OSMAnd, obviously, and you go on the top menu, the right one, you see GPS traces, click on that, and then there loads. And you go to My Traces, which in case of you, it's your traces. And then it should be the last one. You see that I have a lot of them on as private, and that they're the ones that I uploaded with OSM tracker. I have that set on private. For some reason, I don't have it set on private in OSMAnd, so I'm probably OSMAnd. I'll probably have to figure out how to do that. Never mind that. Nobody's going to go into Freshford and use my track to map. So I'll click on Edit Map, and that will open the ID editor. You can also load your track into JOSM. I haven't figured out how to do that, and all my videos are based on the ID editor, so I'm just going to stick with that. So you see we have a map of Freshford, because it jumps to, I presume, the starting point of the track. And it's this, I want to call it fuchsia colored line. And you see there are little rings here, there, there, there. They're all the track points that I've added, and I've actually already started a bit because I didn't want the video to be too long. Good luck with that. And I'm going to go to where I did the introduction, which was over here, because I have since found out what this thing is that I thought was a holy well. It is not a holy well at all. It is actually an ice house, which, if you look here, is not recorded in the National Archive of NIAH, National Index of Architectural Heritage, which it probably should be on. It should probably have a blue dot, because I presume it's the ice house for Upper Court Domain. I will report it, and maybe it'll get a dot and a record. I should have taken a proper picture. Might go again at some point. So I will add this now. You can see there's a ruin here. And I thought it was aligned differently, but I'm just going to go with what is shown here. So use the area tool. This is, of course, nothing to do really with the track. But since I'm trying to map heritage, I can't leave this unmapped. So I have actually gotten the all the tags I need for the ice house, because I've already done a video about it in Innistieg on the Ladies Loop Walk, which incidentally I will mention later on in the video. So I have it all here. And in the editor here, I will change over to the text mode rather than the table mode. And then I can just paste everything into this. And that's all the, well, I could use man-made ice house as well, but it's not used anymore anyway. That's why it's historic. And then I can click on the table view again, and it'll just put it into a table. And unfortunately, I can't add the newly established ref, i.e. NIAH, because it isn't in the index yet. Might do that later on. Back to the track. So I walked through here. I think there was a birch forest here, so I've added that earlier on. I won't go into that now. And I'll add a track point here. You see, I tried to number them. I lost count sometimes, and it doesn't really matter how many there are. But I didn't, then, after a while, I just used TM for trail marker and a number. So it was roughly here. So I add a point, and then because I've done a few already, you have it here in the menu trail marker. So we can just type trail and it should come up. Or you can type this combination, tourism information, information route marker. But just typing in route marker is quicker. And, or trail marker. And then the color on the trail markers is purple. So you can add that as well. Purple. And you see it brings up a little square here. Well, rounded edge square. The purple. It's not exactly that shade, but never mind that. And the material, I think, is that kind of recycled plastic that they're using all over the place now for benches and trail markers. I'm just going to put in plastic. The trail marker, like this, the pole itself is kind of black and, dark gray black. But I think what they're looking for is the color of the trail marker in case, you know, sometimes routes cross and there might be several trail markers. And just to know which one you're following, they use different colors. There is only this one route along this way. And you could also add the elevation, but I didn't have any tools to measure that. And then, of course, we want to add it to the relation. So we'll go down to relations and click on this here. And the route was already mapped as the relation. That makes it much easier. I will do another video about how to do that. And I might have done it already. I can't remember. So you just click here and it brings up all the relations that are within the window. And you see there's a bus route, but that shouldn't really be on it. Because I'm pretty sure the bus doesn't go this way. Maybe it does. I have to figure that out at some point. So there's a lot of boundaries. You can see the townland boundary here, the blue and white line. But at the very bottom, we have the hiking route Freshford Loop. I'm just going to click on that. And just to show you what it's mapped like, so we have a name, Freshford Loop, because that's what's on the signs, route hiking, and the type is route, and that's the type of relation is a route, and then you add the name and what type of route it is, because it could be cycling, could be a bus route, could be a skiing route, it's not very likely in Ireland, and so on. So if I can go back to my marker, by just clicking on it, you see I have to add a role and I just type in route marker and that's it then. And then because I'm lazy and I don't want to type everything again all the time, I'm just going to click on it again and hit Control C to copy it so I can just paste it over here where the next one was, roughly here. So you have to click on the map again and just paste it there. And then there was a step over style here, which I think I've already done. Yeah, so there's a gate here, which you can't go through. You could climb over the gate. Actually, it's a ladder one. So step over styles, you only have one step, basically. And they're usually a combination, really, of a squeezer and a step over style. Usually, I think, and or they're both anyway, but this one had two steps on one side and two steps on the other side, and somebody had put a cement block on this side here because the first step was up quite high, and the material is metal. That's not super important. So I had to add this footpath here as well because I couldn't add the style to the gate as well because it was already the gate. So I will just follow along and you see there's a ring fort here. And later on I talked to a guy. Where did I leave that note? There's a guy living down here. I won't say his name. He's a retired teacher. You can say I stood there for a while. That's why there's a squiggly line. And I asked him about the field names and he had quite a few, but he was just pointing up the hill and that's really no use. I don't want the names, I want the location with the names. But he said this is Kerr's paddock, so I added that. And then I said, oh, there's a ring fort up the hill there. And he said, I've never heard of that, living here a long time. And then later on we talked about field names and I said, oh, but they're so important to record because if sometimes you have a wrath field and then you know that there's a wrath. And he said, oh yeah, it's actually called the wrath. And I said, well, that kind of shows that it's a ring fort there. So I've added that as well. Anyway, He told me the name of this road here, and I must have added it as a note. I thought. Well, this is annoying now. It was the Huntsman Road. So that's obviously an old name for this part of, I don't know, it's only this part of the road, he said. Must have something to do with this forest being part of the upper court domain where people went hunting, obviously. Down with that sort of thing. So Huntsman's Road, I think it's plural, because they're usually hunting in a pack. So we have that. And yeah, that's actually really all I can tell you for this. It continues down here and it's really lovely. And I think somebody has added all the surfaces as well. It's actually grass here. Which I meant to do. I did mapillary along the way. So I took all the pictures along every 5 meters and I thought I would go in later on then and add all the surfaces, but they seem to be done already, so lucky me. And I'll save my changes now and then finish off with the rest of the trail markers and see you in the next bit. So if you wanted to show the relation now on the map, you could try to search for it on the OpenStreetMap website. So just Freshford Loop, and I've tried already, so that's why it's there. And go. And all it will find is this information board here, because I called it Freshford Loop, because that's what it's about. But it won't show us the relation. So that's not great. So we have to go to overpass-turbo.eu. And the last search I did was benchmarks in Dunleary, because my friend Liam found 18 benchmarks there the other day. But that's in another video. So what we do is you type in, you open the wizard, the fourth from the left, and type in lime name equals, and then in quotes, Freshford Loop, because it's two words, it has to be in quotes. And then you don't, well, you could probably just build and run the query there now. No, you can't, because then it will only look on this screen, and obviously the Freshford Loop isn't in Dublin. So you click on build query and you have to move to Freshford, or you could move to Freshford, move your map to Freshford first, of course, that was also an option. And then you can hit run. You could also delete the way and node before that, but we don't have to because we're looking for the relation. So if we run this now, we have the track that was already there, but you see all the dots along here, they're all the trail markers that I've added today, and some of the styles. So there's a style here, it looks like a very short ladder, and there were, I added these picnic tables here, another style, two benches here. I counted the steps, I think I might have forgotten to add that to the map. I think there were 11. And more trail markers, and I've actually added a few more details to Upper Court Domain. The walled garden there, I looked at the Maxer imagery, they seem to be doing a lot of work around there, judging from the difference between the Esri imagery, which could be 10 years old, and the Maxer is more recent, it's about a year, 2 years old, judging from other places where I know they've been building houses and stuff. So when people use this along the way and they're wondering what this is, they might look at their app and then see what it is. And so there's a couple of trail markers, and there's the ice house there, and so on. It would be nice if it actually had a sign up there, if the local history people in Freshford would add a sign for the ice house so people know what it is if they don't use an app. And yeah, that's it, and on to the next part. And just in case you're wondering why you would go to all this bother, to help other people navigate basically, and to spend your time with a purpose. I'm only joking, I'm not. So if you look at OSMAnd, and I'm sure there are other ways in other apps that you can use, but now I'm promoting OSMAnd here because I find it increasingly great. There's a lot of settings you have to consider, but once it's set up, it's great. So if you do hiking, you can choose the hiking layer, which will be displayed up here, and on your phone it'll look a bit different, of course, format. So you go to configure map, and I've already scrolled down. So you can choose modes of transport here: car, bicycle, foot, and public transport. So for hiking, you use by foot. And you can change it for your if you're cycling, for example. And you scroll down here, delete, and you can enable routes, hiking routes. And you probably saw that when we did the when I showed you the relation that is defined as a hiking route, and that's where that comes in. So I enable that and exit this menu, and there's no changes there. But if I zoom in or out and in again, you see that suddenly the hiking routes are displayed. So we have a European long distance path, E8, apart for Ireland. I don't know what people do once they get to the shore. But anyway, there is a loop walk here that I mapped some time ago. The ladies loop, which is signposted here. So it's this part here. And I added the relation ladies loop, and it's displayed here. So when you go along with your app, which I can't show you now because I'm at home, but you'll have your little location dot here, and it'll just follow you around, and it'll make it easier to navigate and to decide which way to go if you're not that great with trail markers, or if the trail markers are missing for some reason. But this way is very well trail marked, and it's a really nice walk, and you can actually do it. You can take the bus from Kilkenny, go to Inisig, do the loop walk, visit the church and the graveyard, and then get on the bus back. So there's time for that. Very green traveling, and I would highly recommend it. I'm sure you know this one because I mapped this one, and the one in Freshford was already mapped in its the route was already mapped, not the trail markers, but I think I added all the trail markers and benches along this one here as well. So that's what you can do, and I would recommend it for anyone who's planning a heritage trail or some hiking trail or whatever, to not just do it in print form and have a nice JPEG or PDF or something, but to also go to the effort of actually tracking it and adding it to OpenStreetMap, because then it can be displayed. If you don't know how to do it, there's a lot of us out there. You can just reach out and we'll do it for you if it's near us. I'm not sure if people are willing to travel. It depends on how much you're willing to pay them, I guess. But I'm sure a lot of us like a bit of walking and exploring and getting that done for you. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.